Hi, my name is Austin. I'm Walt and Tammy's son. I'm 21 years old. I've grown up in Placerville most of my life. Gone to Gold Springs Community Church since it was First Baptist Church of Placerville, so it's been a while. My mom, one day in the van, going somewhere, I don't remember where, asked if I wanted to accept Jesus in my life, and at the time I did, and didn't really know exactly what all that meant. Growing up in church, went to church every day, but it was mainly just going through the motions, didn't really have ownership of my faith. And, after high school, I tried to go to college for 3 semesters and was working full-time at actually Taco Bell on Broadway. But I just felt like I was spinning my wheels, so I ended up enlisting in the Air Force. I shipped out to basic military training, DMT, in San Antonio, Texas, Black Bear Air Force Base, and started my journey as an airman. Right before I went to basic, I had started dating a girl, and we talked back and forth, and you know, sent letters in basic and whatnot, and when I got to tech school, we talked on the phone every day, and she became my first love, the first girl that I ever truly loved. Went to my first duty station at Minot Air Force Base in North Dakota, which is really cold. So after I was there for about a month or two, she couldn't handle it anymore, the distance, so she ended up breaking up with me. And that was kind of like the low point in my life. You know, I always heard all these testimonies where, you know, they come in church, and they come to people coming to Jesus after hitting rock bottom, you know, they find him, and I had never had that. And well, it turns out I found that eventually it happened to me, and that was because, you know, I'm away from home, away from friends and family, didn't really know anyone in North Dakota. I mean, I had a few friends, but they're more like acquaintances, so it was just a really hard time in my life because, you know, my girlfriend broke up with me, and just away from everyone. At that point, my mom, I have to love my mom, thankful for her because she helped me through it. And that's when I really had my kind of God moment, is when I was in that deep slump, that hole. I remember my first God moment was actually, I was taking a friend to Grand Fork. It was a summer night, and there's bugs in North Dakota. There's lots of bugs. They fog up your windshield. Well, I had a Pandora on my radio, and I was listening to it, and it was a Christian radio. I don't remember which one, but a song just hit me, and I started breaking down in tears, just crying. And song after song, you know, it just, they all spoke to me, and I knew it was God speaking to me through the songs and telling me, you know, it's going to be all right, and I'm here for you and all that. So, but where I bring up the bugs, because I was driving at night with the tears in my eyes and bugs, so it was great. It's great fun, great thing. The roads in North Dakota are straight. But that was like my first God moment, and you know, I told my mom about it, and I ended up Skyping her one night and you know, telling her everything, and that's when I actually truly found ownership of my faith. And that's why I told her that I wanted to get baptized. And I wanted to get baptized at my own home church here in Placerville. And so I'm thankful to be able to do that. Thankful for Frank for her being able to do that for me. It's just, you know, I'm on my journey with God and looking up. You know, everything's up from here. So I'm excited to see what He has in store for me.